There are some really easy ways to make your Midjourney images more interesting for social media, creating AI films, or just for fun. You can make them more immersive, animate them, make them talk, create 3D worlds. All of this can be done completely for free, and each of these techniques take less than 2 minutes, some of them just a few seconds, and it does not have to be Midjourney images. They could be from any image generator or even a real photo, if those still exist. MyHeritage AI. MyHeritage is an online genealogy platform with web, mobile, and software products and services. Although not an AI company, they seem to offer AI tools to capture users' interest. In this video, we will try two AI features of this website. Before using their AI tools, make sure you have an account on this site. You can easily register with Gmail or Facebook. You can find the website link in this video description. To animate your photo, first open their Deep Nostalgia menu, or access it from the link in my video description. After that, upload your photo or image, and the AI tool will automatically animate your photo. Here is the AI video animation result of this tutorial. Now let's try their AI video generator. Step 1, open Deep Story AI from the Photos menu and select the Deep Story option. After opening it, click Upload Photo and select your photo or image. Step 2, fill in the person's details and click Next. Step 3, now enter your text or just use the default text. Step 4, select the voice option to change voice accent and languages. After everything is set up, click Create Deep Story button and wait for the process to complete.
Hello, I'm Queen Elizabeth. I would like you to know a little bit about my life.
Pika Lab. The camera control feature allows you to zoom in and out of a video pan in different directions and clockwise direction. Let's try this out inside my private message with a Discord bot. Go ahead and click on animate, and over here, you can provide image, have a look at the result. There has been new feature added that is called Remix, which allow you to change the prompt without adding images. Yeah, so let's go ahead and click on this, and here you can provide your new prompt, so you don't have to add images again and again. This is really good feature. You know, so this time I am just going with camera zoom in, okay. Let's see. So let's have a look at the results. We have it over here. So let's click on this. You could see that, you know how well this zoom in feature works. Let's see how it works. So what we will be doing is we will go ahead and click on this remix, and we will add zero motion, and we will add value 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4, and we will see how it impact the results, right? So let's go ahead and see. So over here we have with 0, let's go ahead and replay this video. So you could see this is a little slower than a previous one for 2. It works a little faster to 0 and 2. The zoom in feature is really fast. So this is how you can change the motion value and impact your output. Kyber AI. And it's super easy to use. Kyber AI is an online platform that lets you create beautiful videos in minutes. You can start with your own image or audio, or use their curated styles and prompt templates. You can also customize your video length, dimensions, camera movements, and more. Kyber.ai use app. State-of-the-art AI generation engine that can make your imagination real. You can direct your own music video, animate your selfies, or create a visual story from your favorite memory. The possibilities are endless to use Kyber AI. You just need to sign up for a free account and get some credits. Each credit lets you create one video of up to 30 seconds. The free version of this is more limited. It's just a 7-day free trial. It is $5 per month for the base plan. After that, click create a video, then begin with an image and upload your photo type in what you want to create in the first section. Then you can tell it what style you want it to create in, or what I recommend, especially at first, is to select one of their styles. You can definitely experiment for yourself. It usually comes back with cool stuff no matter what you put in there. Then select your settings. There's camera movement and how wild you want the animations to get. Then on the next screen, It will generate preview frames to give you a little bit of an idea what it will look like, and you can actually storyboard this out and have it transform and morph into different scenes as it evolves, but it'll just let it run like this. It takes a minute or two depending on how long your video. DeForum. There are a lot of stable fusion-based solutions such as DeForum, but they can be rather unstable and inconsistent at times and also require a lot of prompting and editing. Re-render a video is a new research paper that aims to solve this problem of consistency and stability while still keeping the powerful abilities and community support of stable fusion. Here's a comparison between the baseline stable diffusion animation and the re-render a video animation. Here are some more comparisons between re-render and other recent zero-shot text-guided video-to-video models. As the name suggests, you only require one prompt, which allows the underlying stable diffusion model to convert the input to the best interpreted output. The output can be in different styles and will vary depending on the selected model. Okay, so how do you use it? You first need an input video. After that, enter the prompt. First, click on Run the first keyframe to see if you like the art style of the converted video. If not, change the seed or the prompt and click on Run the first keyframe again. It will take around 10 to 50 seconds depending on the model. If you open the advanced option settings, you can further customize the output. For example, if your prompt isn't affecting the background much, make sure to uncheck Preserve Color. You can also change the base model from Stable Diffusion 1.5 to something else like a Revanimated for CG animations or Realistic Vision for photorealistic style. Run keyframes will apply the selected style and generate the animation for the limited 8 keyframes.
I hope you've learned how you can do it yourself animated video. Make sure to subscribe by